invasive plant species on the forest community of Mount Kilimanjaro. Well, my name is Lawrence Mapunda, and I work with the National Plant Genetic Resources Center. So I will present this very briefly because we don't have so much time. First of all, let us see what are invasive species. And in many cases, there are so many definitions of what is an invasive species, but inherently, both of them, they will mention two things. That invasive species, it has escaped out of its original range. It is not there. I mean, it has been taken away from its original range of distribution. And then it is not an inhabitant or a native to that area where it is taken. And it is invasive because it tends to over proliferate and cover the rest of the land more than the native plants that are found in there. And it has to be alien. And in many cases, people, they confuse. They think that a native species in Tanzania cannot be an alien. A species brought from southern highlands of Tanzania to the Mount of Kilimanjaro, it can also be an alien because that's not the distribution range for that species. So I think that's so much to do with the definitions, invasive alien species. Some of these, there are these terms, naturalization or being established, actually is when at the stage when these plants have been occupying their land and they are by themselves perpetuating and regenerating without the assistance of any from the human being. Why are invasive species successful? And in many cases, these invasive species have been brought into, moved from one area to the other by human being. And mostly from the botanical gardens, all people who have taken those plants for ornamental purposes. And by doing so in botanical gardens, and I gave the example of saying selection is one of the things that makes the species invasive, because the traits that are selected, they make them better to survive in an environment than the native plants. And such selections, like you could see, outstanding, excellent for ordinary garden use, of good constitution, not required specialist growing condition, not susceptible to pest and disease. So the selection procedure, actually, from the botanical gardens or whatever that plant has been brought, they make them more fit than the native one because they have been selected with good habit that they make them survive, and then they override the native plants. So the other characteristics or behavior, most of the invasive species, they aggressively spread, and they have so many seed, and then the range of dispersal is bigger. They can disperse so much faster, and they come to an area where they are enjoying, because in many cases in that area they don't have their enemies or pests and diseases, so they proliferate very fast. So there are so many explanations on this, but these are some of it. Yeah, like I said, the entry points, it depends on the organism, but these are some of the reason why they disperse. Brought to the botanical garden, it always is a human being in the mid of movement of this species. And also, I say there is negligence. For instance, at the mountain Kilimanjaro, there are strict explanation as to why one should not carry any seed or throw any garbage and or introduce any plant in there. But still, human being are very difficult, and sometimes it appears that some species have been introduced on the mountain in that cause. So, invasive species of Mount Kilimanjaro. Mount Kilimanjaro, that's the data, is 1,060 square kilometers, and it is about 6,000 meters high. And however, there is I should say at this point that there is very little work done concerning invasive species on the mountain of Kilimanjaro. Though, as you can see me in the photo there, I was climbing the, like Dr. Mullen said, this January we climbed, and there we are almost at 3,000 something feet on the way to Horombo, one station before you go to Uhuru Peak. I mean, one station before the other station, the last station that you go to Uhuru Peak. So, during this collection, we managed to see some species which have already shown some indicative of invasiveness. And these are the Pinus species, but also at a certain point, we saw the Hodeum grass. It's like a ballet grass that is found at the Horombo. And yet, I can see there is very little attention about what you do. So, actually, I'm not going to show you exactly the invasive species, but the candidate invasive species of the mountain Kilimanjaro. Some of them already already spotted on the mountain, and some of them encroaching. This is one of the candidates, Tridus procumbens, and we have also Cridothema zelanium. Boganese family, and that's a range. You can see there is a range of which it can be found. So, and we have Tagetus minatus, and then we have Oxalis latifolia. We have this one is a highly aggressive, invasive species found now in many places in the close to Mountain Kilimanjaro, and it is very noxious weed. So, we have also Nicandra physolodes. This is one of the worst. It's listed by IUCN among the 34 world worst invasive species. It's found there, and we have Malvastrum chromadelinum. And Hyptis suavellans. And we also have trees. Like I said, these trees, they're found in many coffee plantations. And they are also one of the candidates because at the certain altitude, like you see, they would have survived near the mountain Kilimanjaro. And we have Galinsoga parviflora. We have Euphorbia hilta. Euphorbia heterophylla, Colocasia esculentus, and then coffee also, because this is not a native crop in that area, and it needs to be handled with care, otherwise it would, and together with the practices of cultivation. Like I said, they use trees to cover for the shade, and this, if it's not carefully handled with the climate change, anything can happen. So we need to be more observant on this. We have Agemon mexicana. We have Amaranthus hybridus and the Achyranthus aspera. I've seen, this is the grass that we have found at Rombo. And this is Hodeum species. And we have Pinus. Pinus is very plenty in the Erica, in the Erica shrubland. They are already seeing very virulent into that area. I'm told my time is gone, so I will just say the impact of invasive species. You know, they disturb the biodiversity, and there is competition with the native there, and then they proliferate. These are the global strategies for invasive species. Because of my time, I will not talk so much. These are the resources when you want to read much more about this. And this is the Kilimanjaro. And my conclusion is, we have a very alert situation at the mountain Kilimanjaro, and yet there's nothing much is done concerning the invasive species. And I make a call that this is one of the very important areas that we need to do to conserve the diversity there. Thank you.